Hiya folks, we've just got back from our Scotland trip now.
Scotland?
Where we took Tracy for a new house. Well, a new house, it's not a new house, is it? But they're living up there probably for the next 3 to 5 years. So here's our little video, what we've done of our expedition, Sharon.
Ooh!
To the Highlands, is it? No, it's not the Highlands, is it?
Well, it's well high up.
When you hit the sign that says Welcome to Scotland, you then got another 4 hours to drive.
Only?
Yeah. So that's what's happening in this video. But before that, we took them to a little private swimming pool. And they had a little splash of hat in the pond. So
you're
in
gonna pond.
In the pool. You're gonna see that first. So
yeah,
we'll see you in a minute. I've got to show you this, folks. I've got to show you this. I want you to go to a toilet. We've never been here before, right? So this is the toilet, right? Look, let me turn the camera around. Right, so there's the toilet. Look. Right next to the pool. So I've come in here to go to the toilet. Shut the door behind me. So I'm sitting down here, just having the poo. And look, who's watching me go to the toilet, look. They was all there watching me, look, from under there, look. Unbelievable. I've not had a nice toilet, I've not had a nice number twos, because I was being watched. Unbelievable. Baby Frank's first time in the pool. Is that nice, baby Frank? He's back with mummy, look. Tracy's a non-swimmer, can't you, Tracy? Yeah. Is this more like Cyprus now?
No.
Are you in the pool? It's like being in the bath, isn't it?
Nothing more.
Is it? Anyway, folks, while they're there having fun, I'm just gonna sit outside because tomorrow morning we've got a long journey in front of us, and that is going up to Scotland.
Bonnie Scotland.
Yeah.
If you go, it's snowing.
Apparently it's snowing, isn't it? Right, folks, we've just made it up here. We're in Lossiemouth, actually. This is Tracy's new house. And the Vauxhall Vectra actually made the journey faultlessly. So we did have a little few suspect fear people saying that they thought the head gasket might be an issue, but it's got up here first class. We're going to just check the water now just to make sure that we haven't lost any water on a journey, and check the oil and stuff like that. So it's done 500 miles in this journey, and it took us in total, we did stop off a few times, it took us about 11 hours. So let's have a look at the Vectra and see how it's fared on that journey. Let's get it open. Let's get that bonnet up. Down there. As I say, it performed absolutely faultlessly. Where's the bonnet lift on here? There we go. Let's get that up in here. And all I can say is that it's still sitting on the exact mark. There's a little arrow there with a little arrowhead there. You probably can't see it. And as you can see, I had it just slightly overfilled, and it's still slightly overfilled above the arrow there. So it's not lost any water at all in a 500 mile journey, which it's just done. It has not lost any oil whatsoever. It's still sitting right at the top of the line there. So well happy with that. As I say, it's a great old car, this. And that's it. That's the old Vauxhall Vectra. Happy days, living in Scotland now. So there's old Project Man's van. I got insured for 7 days on that. And that moved a load of furniture up as well. So it lives here now. They was also given this Ford Fiesta by Ben's parents. So they've got these two cars basically for nothing, which is nice, isn't it? Happy days. So we're just coming in. This is the house they live in. Hello, you two.
Hi.
Hello. Tracy's just done a big dinner for us, and it was fantastic. Wasn't it?
Yeah.
They're both dressed in their uniforms, look. Work uniforms.
I know.
Nanny's not too well, are you, Nanny?
No.
You're not too well. She's had a bit of chesty stuff.
You have Jaffa cakes as well. You have two of those.
Jaffa cakes?
And then two of those.
Look at you.
You've had one
already. Oh, I've overeaten this week, haven't you? Yeah. Right, so that's where we are, folks. So as you can see, we're right on the coastline there. And Elgin apparently is the nearest town, which is coming from there. We're about here at the moment, somewhere up here. And this is well known for having dolphins and seals along here anyways. This is the Moray Firth, is it? Along there, I think you'll find. And it's actually twinned with a German town called Hirschbruck. Look what we found, George. Look, it's an old lobster pot. Look. Yeah, look. Stuck in the ground. Look. Here, look. There's another one. Look. They've been washed up, haven't they? You two. With all this seaweed here. Look. See, Ben. Look. See, they built them right.
Yeah.
That's the base, the concrete base there. But they've only put that much of cement underneath to support them. That's why they've all fallen over, isn't it?
It is.
Perhaps cement was hard to come by back in the 1920s or 30s, Ben.
Yes, that's it.
Yeah, look, they've not gone very deep with the cement at all, especially in sand, Ben.
Yeah.
Yeah?
You wouldn't expect them to do anything, would you?
Well, there you go.
In your pocket.
Here we go, shall we? Look, these ones further up, look. For some reason, they're a lot bigger.
No, they're not actually. They're just standing up.
No, they're wider, Sharon.
No, they're not.
They're wider pillars, aren't they, Ben?
No, I think these are just buried.
Hey?
Yeah, these are just
buried. Oh, are they?
I think so, yeah.
So they was all this size then, you think?
You can tell us by looking at them.
Yeah, you've got a point there, actually. So that was the full width of them. Half of them have been buried in the sand, folks.
Oh, they've got hook things on the top.
Yeah, little hooks. That might have had a fence along the top of it, yeah. And the further we get down the beach, as you can see, folks, they're more standing up, maybe because of this higher sand line here. Has protected the wind. Maybe, who knows? Oh, no, it's defending the country. Look at that, look. So there's a lighthouse up there. We'll make our way there. And apparently there's some caves up here as well. So if we can, we're going to investigate that a little bit. So, I don't know what caves these will be. This big rock here, the lighthouse is actually right at the top there. So, these caves are literally right underneath. I don't know whether there'll be any cave entrances leading to the lighthouse, Sharon. You know, there. Let's have a look, shall we? It's a bit dark. Oh, it's a bit spooky in here, isn't it? Hey. Look at that.
Hello.
It's just a cave, isn't it?
It says hello. That's quite creepy.
You imagine over the years how many people have been in and out of this place.
Hello.
Look.
It says hello.
Hey.
Nanny, hello.
You don't like it, Nanny, do you?
As far as I'm going.
No.
No going, Nanny.
Yeah.
Okay, go to the big one.
Look at that. How old is that, folks? Let's have a look at the bigger one, shall we? It's a bit spooky, baby, isn't it?
Let's just see if I can get my torch off.
Yeah, no, it won't brighten it up enough in there, shall
we? Can't be, isn't it?
No, I've got plenty of light in there, shall we? God, can you imagine standing here overnight?
Somebody has.
Yeah, really? What you got around the corner there, baby?
Oh,
there's a little corner there. Someone's been
so
carving.
You're shielded, haven't you?
Yeah, it's gone all dark, shall.
Ooh, okay, got in there.
Yeah.
Oh, getting out.
Yeah, all cut out of the rock.
Found a massive one.
Let's go and have a look at the other cave then. Come on in. So as we come around the corner, folks, up this sand dune here, there's the top of the lighthouse. You can see it there, but we've got these massive caves that have been carved out. Whether they're natural or what, I don't know, but we're going to have a little look up there. Quite hard to get to. Walking up on the sand, folks. Wow, look at that.
Gangi, on that wall it says Emily.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, look, right around there.
Oh.
What's around there, Ben?
Just Emily.
Any steps there? My Nanny wouldn't like this.
Nanny would not like that.
Right now, it just ends there.
Just a crevice, isn't it?
Yeah. No, wait, that
fragment. Wow. Water dripping through.
Yeah, Emily, pull down there. Down
there. Don't do it, Ems. Yeah, look at this, look. Looking out at Nanny, she doesn't like things like this. I don't know whether this has been carved out, Ben. Look at the separation between the rocks up there. Well, I don't think the sea comes up here, does it? And there's another small one down that side, isn't there?
I don't know, it could have been here, isn't it?
It might have been up here, yeah. And you've got these just little ones here, folks. In there, look. There we go, look. And there's some sort of little, perhaps, lookout up there. Now, there you go. Little caves, natural caves maybe. Always people going in there trying to get up to the lighthouse, you don't know, do you? Who knows? So we've now walked up to this lighthouse. We can't look any nearer because it's a private residence. So if you look over in the distance there, you can see Lossiemouth. And that lighthouse would have protected us from the North Sea invaders. All right, so we just found a little sign here. Cove Sea Lighthouse, folks. There are two keeper cottages available for holiday rental. This Cove Sea cottage has two bedrooms. Halliman cottage has three bedrooms. There you go. So look, we thought it was private residence.
Look, it's open up the top there.
I don't know if you can go up there, Shell, can you?
Working, is it working like us? And
I don't know. Does it still work, Ben?
I don't know.
Does it work?
No, it was decommissioned. Look.
Decommissioned, was it? When? Did it say when? By the Northern Lighthouse Board. There you go. These must be dotted all the way along the coastline, I would have thought. And over there, from the lighthouse, you can see there's a caravan park as well. Is that RAF Lossiemouth over there, Ben, isn't it? And that's where Ben's going to be working. That's why the whole reason why he's up in Lossiemouth for the next 5 years, with my daughter and family. Right, we're just on our way down from the lighthouse now. And we're more down in level peggings with that caravan site. But there's some sort of hut there. Look, looks like some sort of...
There's a nice Merlin.
A what?
Merlin.
A Rottweiler, yeah. Over there. There's some sort of little tower there, Sharon, as well, behind that tree there. Look.
Merlin.
It's been capped off by the looks of it. I wonder if it was a gunnery shell.
My birdie's got some growing to do, looking at him.
I'm coming down here, so some old, looks like stable block, Sharon. Look, in front of us.
Yeah, it does, it?
Possibly. She's a bit puffed out because she's got a bit of a chest infection, folks. So I've had to sort of carry her, really.
Not carry me, drag, well, drag me.
Drag you. I've dragged you about, baby, haven't I? Yeah. Is there anything showing a date on it, Ben?
Oh, I think I know where these are.
Looks like, oh, are they stables?
No, well, they're not. No, they're
C5. Wonder where they are. They're very small. Look. There's a little trough there for the water to run out.
I'm
these ain't stables. Look, there's a little shelf there. These might have been old holiday let, Sharon. Yeah? Look, you've got a solid floor here. There would have been two pillars there in the floor, maybe. And maybe that was a raised bunk there. Look, maybe two holes there. Pillars along the wall there. Look, you can see where wooden battens been. And maybe that was some sort of raised sleeping platform or something. I don't know. Little slit window there. Very unusual. And a little slit window that side. Looks like it had access for maybe a chimney there. I don't know. Not too sure. So there you go. Don't know what these are. Let's come out of this one. You've got that there. Are they all the same, Shell?
Warm though, when you walk in them.
Yeah, but they're solid brick, aren't they? They're quite thick and all, aren't they? Oh yeah, these are living accommodation of some sort, isn't it? Yeah, who knows?
But it's so warm in it. Look at that roof.
Maybe people used to live in here.
100 years.
For defending the country, maybe. Who knows? Maybe it was holiday, that's who knows, Sharon.
That one must have a fireplace in, look.
Yeah, the end one must have. There's two chimneys there, aren't
there? I'm cold.
So yeah, what annoys me, Shell, is that with all this lovely natural beauty here, people can do that. Look, they throw a bag of dog poo just off of a pathway, look. Rather than take it with them, or even burying it, because it's only sand, they just throw it in there, Shell, don't they? And this is a dog we haven't seen before, isn't it? This is another Cyprus dog. This is Nigel, the German Shepherd. In fact, you did see him on one of my vlogs.
Yeah, the first time.
Yeah, he was only a puppy then, but he's now massive.
And he's a big boy.
He's a big boy. Nigel. Nigel!
It's a son
of
buddy.
Nigel!
He's having his dinner
look. I know he is, baby. Oh, of course, they've seen him on the vlog anyway, Sharon. He was at the beach when he jumped on that high rock, wasn't he?
Yeah, wasn't he on that high rock?
Tell him what he's grazed on when he jumped up there, Sharon.
His balls.
His testicles. He's grazed his balls, that. You see that when he jumps up, he actually caught them. But that was Ben, he made him do that. Nothing to do with me, Sharon.
Oh, Ben.
Anyway. Right, so we're going to finish the vlog here now. And, we just thought we'd bring you along for our little journey, what we've done. And we've had a lot of fun over this last couple of days, even though Mummy's not been too well.
I know.
And you've got a lot of moving to do, haven't you, baby?
A lot.
Are
you talking to me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course I am. So, I've not had a video out for a while, but we're going to put this one out when I get back, because I've got no editing software. So, we'll see you in the next video, Shell, when we're back in the UK.
Yeah, we'll see how long the journey takes.
Yeah, we're hoping it's going to be a lot quicker going down there. It should be 8 hours and 44 minutes. Going downhill, Shell, yeah, literally. 8 hours and 44 minutes. Oh, you got me anywhere.
Sorry, it's only water.
So we'll see you folks in the next video. And until then,
bye for now.
Bye for now.